described and captioned media program. In the classroom and online, dcmp.org.
Human Relations Media presents Coping with the Body Image Blues.
Double walks up.
That's it? You're done?
Yeah, I ran like 3 miles.
And you think that's gonna work off your lunch?
Okay, I'll do another one.
At least, can't let those pounds build up.
The girl gets up from the bench and jogs away. In a kitchen, a heavyset teenager in a baseball cap walks to the fridge past his double.
You playing the Badgers today?
Oh, whoa!
Yeah? With that creep Sherman, the one who always calls you Tubby?
The teen frowns sadly.
Yeah.
I think I know just the thing to cheer you up.
The double opens the fridge and takes out a cheesecake.
Yeah?
Does kind of look good.
On a stage, a young man with a bass guitar sits on a stool.
Body image. You know what that is? It's the way you see yourself in your head and the way you think other people see you, not necessarily the true you. In fact, it's usually nothing like the true you. Those kids we just saw, we've all felt like they do sometime or other. I know I did. It's what I like to call the body image blues.
He plays a tune and sings.
Woke up this morning with a pimple on your chin, and you're looking like a monster. You're never gonna grin. Sure, you're way too skinny, or sure, you're way too fat, but it really hurts the ego to think you're not all that. But it's all just foolish thinking, even though it feels too real. You're coping with those crazy old teenage body image blues.
Yeah. So what causes the body image blues? I mean, where do we get this idea about what we should look like? Well, mostly it comes from three places: from our family, from our friends, and from the media. TV, magazines, advertisements, rock stars, athletes.
Natalie, eighth grade.
What you see on TV kind of puts in your mind that these people are wearing perfect clothes and they have perfect lives.
Brian, 11th grade.
My idea of perfection was from the media, all like the athletes and movie stars that I saw on TV, and how they had like the perfect hair, perfect skin and everything.
Whenever I get a new Teen Vogue.
Sydney, eighth grade.
I always look through it and I'm like, I wish I had hair like her. I wish I had her shoes. I wish I had long nails like her. I wish I didn't have glasses because her eyes are so pretty.
My friends,
Kevin, 10th grade,
often pressure other kids to, I guess, look another way, not necessarily by telling them, but making fun of them sometimes.
Josh, 11th grade.
I think most kids do fall into the trap of believing what the media tells.
The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deaf-blind. These services include a library of free-loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approved lists of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.